Automating lights and making them smart is one of the quick wins of every smart home. Why? Because they are immediately visible from every family member or guest, and most importantly, they can save your money by reducing the electricity cost in the long run. But what are the possible ways to convert an existing bulb or light into a smart one without breaking the budget, without complicated rewiring procedures, or without damaging the design of your rooms? Well, there are three recommended ways, and they all have some pros and cons. Let's discuss. The recommended ways to make your lights smart are to use a smart bulbs, to use a smart relays, or to use a smart switches. And I'll cover all of them one by one in a minute. But have in mind that there is one very important question that is valid for all three ways. And the question is, how are you going to control, combine, and automate your smart lights? The answer to that question and that problem is a smart home hub. But attention here, not any smart home hub is local and universal enough to allow you to add most of the smart home products available. In my humble opinion, the best possible smart home hub at the moment is Home Assistant. The second best is Home Assistant, and third best is Home Assistant. Probably on fourth place is Alexa and Google Home voice assistants, but they are not local. To learn more about Home Assistant, again, that's the best possible smart home hub at the moment, I want to invite you on my Home Assistant webinar, where I'm talking about the all four official and supported ways to get it. Plus, one secret and super simple way to get started with Home Assistant on your PC in under 5 minutes. The webinar is completely free and you can register on my website automatelike.pro/webinar. One more thing that I want to say before we begin is that this video is not sponsored by anyone. I'm sharing my own opinion and experience so far. With that being said, the first possible method to make your existing lights smart is to buy a smart bulb or bulbs and to replace your existing dumb bulbs with them. This method is probably the easiest, as the smart bulbs are no different in form and size than their dumb brothers and sisters. Smart bulbs are designed for installation in a standard light sockets, like E27. All that have to be done is to unscrew the old dumb bulb and to screw the new smart bulb, and then to pair it with your smart home hub. The smart bulbs are relatively cheap, and both white and car models are available, so this is another big plus of this method. But what are the minuses? The first one is that if you switch off the bulb from your light switch, you will lose the wireless connection with your smart bulb, and you will not be able to control it from your hub and home automations. That means you have to turn on the light switch and to literally leave it in that position forever, so you can always have wireless access to the bulb from the hub, phone, voice, or whatever. Next minus is that this method is not universal. In other words, if you don't use standard dumb bulbs, the conversion will be not as easy. Imagine the following scenario. You already have an expensive and beautiful LED lights in your room. Would you like to remove these LED lights and to place one single smart bulb instead? The answer will be probably big no. In such a case, the second and third methods that I'll talk about in few moments are going to be much better choice. The smart bulbs that I used so far are from Shelly, Switchbot, and Sonoff. I'm most happy with the Shelly bulbs, as they're out-of-the-box Home Assistant compatible and you can start automating them right away. The next method is to use a smart relay. This is probably the cheapest method, but it requires some electricity wiring skills and a place where you can hide the relay. The usual possible places to hide the smart relays are two: behind the light switch or inside the cover of the lights. That is, of course, if you are converting existing lights. If you're wearing brand new ones, you have more hiding options. With smart relays, you can also wirelessly cut off yourself exactly the same way as with the smart bulbs. That means, if you turn off the light switch, you will lose wireless connection to the smart relay until you turn on the light switch again. And believe me, realizing that you have no access to your smart lights because someone has turned off the light switch is happening all the time. And it is happening exactly when you want to use that smart feature the most. Basically, you have to stand up and turn the lights on manually, which is kind of frustrating and not very different than having a dumb lights at first place. What I said until now for the smart relays can be considered as cons. But these are the pros of using smart relay method. Depending on the brand and the model, the smart relays can add few other benefits like showing the electricity consumption, which is a very nice feature. Also, there are relays that can be installed on places where you have no neutral wire, which is also a big plus. On top, some relays have embedded safety features like overheating, overpower and overvoltage protection. What I used until now and what I can recommend are the Sonoff Smart Relays and Shelly Smart Relays. Both brands are just fine. Sonoff relays are a bit cheaper and easier to operate, but they cannot work out of the box with Home Assistant. For them, you have to add either some custom components or you have to flash them with another firmware like Tasmota or ESP Home. These procedures are not that hard, but for beginners, they could be challenging. Shelly relays, on the other hand, are a bit more expensive, but they're better in almost every aspect. They come with more features, they have more built-in protection mechanisms, and they can work with Home Assistant out of the box. I will leave some links in the video description of some tutorials of mine about the relays that I reviewed so far, if you want to know more about them. Before I move on, I must say that I'm constantly using some smart home words and abbreviations that may not sound familiar with you. To help you easily understand them, and not to explain every single time I use them in my videos, I created one PDF document that I called the Smart Home Glossary. Inside that glossary, you can find simple but useful explanations of every smart home word or acronym that I could think of. Download this glossary free of any charge from my site and use it whenever you like. Now, let's move to the third possible method to make your existing lights smart. In this method, all that you have to do is to replace your old dumb light switch with a smart one. The procedure is a little harder than changing a bulb. That was the first method that we talked about. But in most cases, it should be easier than adding a smart relay, which was the second method listed in this video. The smart switches are usually having from 1 to 4 buttons. They have versions that can work with or without neutral wire, which is a big plus. And you cannot cut off easily your wireless connection to your lights. When you press the smart switch hardware button to turn off the lights, you will still be able to power on the lights wirelessly using your hub, phone, voice or whatever. In my opinion, using smart switches is probably the best option so far. But unfortunately, it is also the most expensive one. The switches that I used so far are again from Sonoff, and again they require a bit more work to be added in Home Assistant. I'm also having some Shellys, which basically are offering relays with a well-designed light switches that can hold the relay. I also have some Aquara light switches as well. I think I'm most happy with Aquara here, but they're using Zigbee for the wireless communication. So, what to finally choose to convert your existing lights into a smart light? There is no definite answer to that question. It all depends on your existing lights, your budget, and your wiring skills if you wish. If you are a beginner, I can suggest to start simple and fast with a smart bulb or bulbs. Test, validate, hook up, and then proceed with other methods if needed. If you are an advanced user and connecting few wires is not scary for you, go for the smart relays. If you are somewhere in the middle and you have the budget, try smart switches and stay there. As I said, this is probably the best option in most of the cases. I will leave some affiliate links in the video description to all of the smart bulbs, relays and switches that I'm using, so you can check their current prices. Affiliate links means that I will receive a small commission if you decide to buy something from these links, and this will not add any additional cost for you. Thank you for watching. I'm Kirill and I'm done speaking. Bye!